Okay, I'm going to do a quick video on the Macro Multi-Cruiser, and this is a waterproof machine. It's on 5 kilohertz, 14 kilohertz, or 19 kilohertz. It's just, you know, selectable one frequency at a time. And it's got your all metal mode. It's got your two-tone, three-tone, four-tone. It's got the beach mode. It has a deep mode that's, how should I say, two-tone. But it gives it a little boost. And all the tones are able to have set points for the break, for the tone break. Plus, you can set the tones for each segment, you know, hertz wise, from low to high. And has iron volume and regular disc, like any metal detector. Plus, it has notching. Plus, it has the ability, when you notch something, to have it, instead of being nulled, to create a tone that you can control the volume of. Instead of having it quiet, you can have it in the background, you know, so the audio gate stays open instead of going shut and then starting back up, sort of like on the Impact, or exactly like the Impact. Then it has volume, backlight, has the vibrate feature, has ground tracking, and your frequency selection, and ability to save each tone you're in, to save the settings in that, you know, tone. And has wireless headphones. It's got a built-in battery. Everything's sealed up. I don't know if you can see it or not, but everything's sealed. And it's a very robust machine. Has the option of adding a emergency power supply, which is very ingenious, really. It bolts in under, or screws in with some thumb nuts. And I'll show you that in a few minutes, but it sets up in here. Four double A's, little pod, then it screws into your headphone jack port right here, plus your charging port. It'll screw in here, and then what'll happen is the pod will actually have a place to put your headphones, plug your headphones in, the waterproof ones, or just with a dongle, you can use any headphone you want. And the same on the back of the machine, if you can just, there's a dongle you can screw on the back of the machine and use any headphone you want if you don't want to use the wireless. But the machine also has a couple little extra features in it, you know, that I guess the Impact does have too. But I can have my ID be the same on any frequency, or I can change it to be the exact ID for that frequency. And has this little extra underground depth feature that the Impact doesn't have. And what I'm mainly going to do is just show you the different frequencies on my 10-inch dime, and the different tone modes. But right now I'm in, I don't know if you can see it or not, but if I go to my options here and scroll down, I'll start out at frequency 5. And we'll start out at two-tone. And my two-tone, my settings, I'll just leave everything stock. I reset everything stock to the factory, except my gain in this mode is on, put it on about 98. No disc. Got the notch down. Zero. No notching. And I've got the iron volume turned up to 5 so we can hear it. And the tone breaks and all that's just the factory settings. Now this is on, I'll do a ground grab for you. This is on 5 kHz. I'm sorry, that's the wrong one. Ground's at 81. And it's showing 3 bars. And then the bars on this one go up to, I believe, 1, 2, 3, 5. So here's the 10-inch dime on 5 kHz. In two-tone. Then I'm going to go to 3-tone. Still in 5 kHz. And everything is maxed out. The gain's maxed out on this, and we're on 0 disc. Okay, there's 4-tone. Now the 4-tone's deeper than the 3-tone. As you can hear, it's a little more sparky. I get a hit. My ID's in the lower 90s, jumping into the upper 70s. So that's a 10-inch dime. And then we can go deep mode, and I don't think I've messed with anything here. So let me turn my gain up on deep. Disc on 0, notch on 0, everything else will be stock. I'm in the mid to upper 90s and then occasionally 80, 81. So we're getting close to the dime ID in that mode. So that's all the modes. Let me back up to 2-tone again. And let me go into the frequency. Now we're going to jump up to 14. And I'm going to do another ground grab. It's 82. And it's still showing 3 bars right there on this setup. So let me do, this is 2-tone, 14. Three-tone. Four-tone. What you're going to find is you change the frequency, the different tones are a little bit deeper on one than they are the other, just the way it processes. When you go to different tones, you're going to different process modes too. So here we come across, this is a deep. So the 5 kHz really likes that deep mode. And the 14 really likes that 3-tone. Let me go back up to 2-tone. Go in the options. And I'm going to go 19 kHz. Let me do a ground grab. It's 82. showing three bars. Okay. Two-tone. 19. Four-tone. Well, we did have a 79 idea. We're about wanting to stabilize on that. About 79. This four-tone. And when it does hit, it's wanting to show it around a 97 on the ID. Then we'll go deep. And the ID is just all over the place on that. So if you're going to run the, looking for deep silver, I would probably choose, in a clean area, I would probably choose 5 kilohertz in deep mode. And then if I was in more of a trashy area, I'd go to 14 kilohertz and 3-tone. That seems to be the best for that. But, there is the extra underground depth, and I can show you that. And to turn it on, you gotta get the flashing light on this DUV. Extra underground depth is supposed to help you. Then go back to 2-tone in the EUD mode. Not long as it's flashing around the thing, the EUD's turned on. Give you a little turkey gobble in that 3-tone. That sounds good. Let me see, what else can I do? I'm going to go back to the 5 kilohertz and use the EUD. On that deep, I believe that was our... Let's see, let this thing clear. There we go, setting. We'll go to deep, EUD turned on. So, this is the EUD turned off. Deep at 5 kilohertz. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go, I got this big coil, and I hate to do a nail board test with the big coil, but I'll let you see it anyway. See where we're at. And some small coils will help stretch it out. You know, separation and all that. And I'll show you the battery pod. But one thing I can speak of highly on this metal detector is the build quality. It's I've been using the phrase par excellence. It's got this little rubber boot right here, sort of just to keep the trash out. But get this little connector in there, a little waterproof connector. This is just a little safety boot, just to keep, like if you're on the beach, keep all the sand out of your, you know, threads. And it's basically, it's simply mounted. It's just one screw. And the whole thing is self-contained in this pod. And you can see the bulkhead here. Screwed in all the way around. And all this around the edges is rubberized. And the buttons are rubberized. So everything's self-contained in this one pod. Sorry, put my hand in front of the lens. It's got the 7x11 coil like the racers and the all of the, you know, machines that the Macro makes. But it'll run about 12 hours, I found, without headphones, about 15 with headphones. A little less if you're using the 5 kilohertz machine. Sides, you know, flexible, but it's really high, it comes up around the sides of your arm real well, fits good and snug. Just a sturdy built metal detector, and it's got performance. I mean, like all the Macnox, you know, they're unmasked extremely well, they're deep. See on the 10-inch dime, it's hitting the 10-inch dime, and on like a F-75, T2, things like that, that's 4-bar dirt, and this one here is doing about 3-bar. If I go to 19 kilohertz, there's little spots in here, it'll go to a little higher on the bars, but the lower frequency will keep the bars down a little lower. I need to show you that battery pod. Carbon fiber lower shaft. And I guess that's for the water, so you won't get no flex. And it doesn't flex. I mean, it's just trying to push it on the ground there sideways. It's not giving. So it's a very durable machine. And what I'm going to be using it for is an all-terrain machine. Just, you know, everywhere. You hunt in the rain, you ain't got to worry about it. Still got excellent performance. And it's just a well solid built machine. Got your frequency options so you can tailor to the targets you're after. And I mean, can't say nothing bad about the machine. It's just a solid machine. Other manufacturers really need to take note of how well this machine is built. I mean, it's just a solid machine. It's a little nose heavy, but I mean, with that coil, but I mean, it ain't nothing no more than anything else. I mean, it's just solid. It'd get a little bit heavier if you had the battery pod on it, but if you charge your batteries, it's going to last all day, maybe 2 days, I mean, according to how hard you're hunting. But to me, it's like a waterproof impact. I mean, that's what kind of performance I see out of it. Basically the same depth, same unmasking, things like that. I mean, sounds about the same. I can tailor the tones to higher, you know, I like higher tones, especially when I'm in a lot of iron. I really like to get that high tone up around 700 hertz so I can pick out those little chirps. I don't have any smaller coil. I've got a impact coil, and the impact coil will work on this. I've got, but it's I can't swing it because the cable's so short, so I don't use it. But all in all, it's just a quality built metal detector that can suit any kind of needs. You know, inland hunting, it's got all metal mode. You can prospect with it on 19 kilohertz. It's got all the different coils you can, you know, it's got the 4.5 by 7, the 5 by 10, the stock. It's got the big, was it 13? It's got the concentric 7. So it's got a slew of coils already available for it. So you can pretty much, this machine can be tailored to do anything you want. And I know in the Gulf, these machines run extremely well on wet salt beaches and like small gold. And that's in the Gulf. I can't tell you nothing else. Or black sands and all that. But in the Gulf, very good machine, especially when you put the 5x10 on. Swings really well in the water. So has good depth. And even in the beach mode, where it's running a little higher factory disc, you know, you want it to get your iron grind the way it's set up, and when your ground balance to the wet salt, the iron grunt really won't be there for you no more, but because it'll be notched out or blanked out. But excellent machine. You can take it anywhere, do anything. And let me just move on now to the nail board test, and I'll show you the battery pod and a couple of the accessories. All right, hang on. Okay, so what we got, we got us a little dongle here. And it just, you know, screws into the back of the machine here. And this charging jack, just screw it in. I can't do it with one hand, but you screw it in. It's a multi-pin, as you can see. And this jack also is for charging and all that, so all the pins do different things. Anyway, you can screw that in. It's got a stereo jack on this end, so you can plug your headphones in. You need any kind of headphones you want. Or you've got the standard wireless headphones you can get, and use the wireless option as long as you don't have the, it's a waterproof to 15 feet, so as long as you don't have the box under the water, you could just use the wireless headphones. You'd be just like wading in 3 foot of water or something like that and wouldn't even need it to worry about it. But also you've got this battery pod here, and it's just takes a 4AA alkaline holder. It screws together. Drop it in, screw it together. And then this would screw into the back of the machine in that same charging and headphone jack port. And this thing here, flip it over. Thing here is very unique, really. You take this and you set it down in there just like that, and then you've got this little cup here that you can put on it, and you screw the screws down, and It's also got its own detector stand built on the bottom to hold it. Let's see if I can. It's hard to do things with one hand, but I think you get the idea. And then what you would do is, I don't have it connected, but what you got here is a little battery pod. You just hook this up. And if you still wanted to use land headphones, you just then take and screw it in here to that adapter over there. You would screw it in on this right here if you wanted to, while you was running the machine off a backup battery supply. So very unique if you got it, you know. And it's well thought out, really. I mean, the way it's engineered. So if you got, you know, out hunting and just all of a sudden your battery goes dead, you're still set to go. And it's not really that heavy. It's four double A's. I mean, it's like a machine with four double A's under the armrest. But for most applications, you're never going to need that. It's just, it's there if you do need it. And that's an option. That's, you don't have to have that. That's just an optional accessory. But what we're going to do now is I'll show you the nail bore test. I like this eagle button, so I'm going to use this eagle button. Eagle button's a mid-conductor. So let me turn the machine back on. Here, I thought he's still going to be in this stock mode. And I believe I'll just do a... I'm going to leave it on 90 ground balance. And let me just turn my disc down. I ain't gonna mess with anything else. It gets too complicated just to sit here and run through it. But let you hear a nail. And we're well above the nail. That big nail's reading 5. And I think the factory tone break, just where we are, is at 15. So, here's one. This is 3 tone. Here's 2. That's the mid tone. Sweep. I can take and turn that iron volume down so you can, let me see, go to my settings here. Yeah, feed volume. Let me rack it down to about 2 so it'll get. Yeah. So. Now, this is a big coil, too, so don't forget that. Now, here's the 4. So, pretty dang good. They have such a big coil and still be doing so good. Here's the one over here by itself. This will be tough because we have such a big coil, but because as you can see, now that's with this 7x11 coil, I can, I mean, for whatever it's worth, let me turn this thing off, for whatever it's worth, I can pass that nail board test with the 7x11 coil in any direction using that Eagle Coat button. So, and that's on just 14 kilohertz. I can get better, but I didn't, you know, I wanted to keep everything just middle of the road. Didn't want to set my tone brakes and all that and go to a high, the 19 kilohertz works better. But just middle of the road, I want to show you how good a macro, and even their sister company, the Nocta. Just wanted to show you how good they are for dissecting iron when you really want to get in there and sift iron. And you put smaller coils on it, it gets even better. You know, starts getting amazing. So I think the nail board test there will show you just, I know a lot of people's got the nail, they can do it at their self at the houses and all that, so it's sort of a universal thing. The one I worry about more than anything is just that down the barrel, trying to hit a target, you know, down that nail. But I think it just shows you how good of a machine we have here in the cruiser, and all, and everything it can cover. We can sift through iron, you know, dissect, get those clean hits in there, and heavy iron. We can get depth, you know, it's right there in that F75 range. It's, you know, it's tickling it, it's right there on it. Plus we have the option of fine tuning our frequencies to suit what we're hunting for. The 5 kilohertz really likes that deep mode if you're going after deep, big stuff, you know. Think belt buckles, half dollars, silver dollars, any kind of buckle, big brass buckles, Rev War buckles, deep stuff. It really likes that, that 5 kilohertz. 19 kilohertz is more for the low stuff, the buttons, things like that, you know, in nails. But when, if you got a machine like this cruiser, it's just something you can use anywhere, you know. And the best part of it is the unmasking ability. And the depth, you know, it's just going to stay right there with whatever's out there. And that's all soil dependent too, you know. I don't get a whole lot into that depth stuff because everybody's soil's different and things are different. But you get to get your sweet speeds right to get depth. Some people say some machines ain't as deep as them, but they might be swinging it too fast or they're swinging it too slow. So, you know, it's hard to say anything about depth, but I do know that macro, Nocta, they do work well in bad soil for depth because of the way the filters are in the machines. They're what I like to call bleedy. They let stuff break through. You know, it's not overly trying to silence that ground noise, so anything that's down there is sort of getting a peek through it. Some machines are overly filtered and trying to stay quiet on rejected things. So, I mean, these machines can be noisier, but they're clean running machines once you get your ear tuned to them. And they do a lot of the work for you. I mean, you can get a lot of machines that'll dissect iron, but you really got to know what you're doing with them. I mean, you really got to work with them and spent years using them, you know, decades of running, hunting iron. I mean, dissecting iron with high frequencies and noise, and just to figure out how to run them, you know, just to their fullest extent. But you can take these machines, and I've always said it's more like you're cheating because of what they can do through the audio. The audio is very nuanced and talkative. So to me, this machine here is a great machine to have. If a man only had this machine and wanted to hunt everywhere, I mean, and once or twice a year on your beach trips, salt water, wherever you might go, or, and surely fresh water, great fresh water, good ID system. They got a very good ID system, actually, very accurate. But if, I mean, if a man only had one machine, he's not going to be outgunned in iron. He's going to hold his own, you know, through skill levels and all that, of depth. And if that's the only machine you've got, you're not going to be outgunned hardly anywhere, you know. So, great all-around machine that can compete on a world-class level unmasking and hang with the big boys on depth. You know, it's sturdy build. It's just an excellent machine. You know, it's all a machine anybody would need until some kind of new technology comes out. I mean, as far as in a VLF package. So anyway, maybe that video's helped a little bit. I was waiting on the factory to see if they was going to do a software update. I don't know if they have or not, but I went ahead and made a video anyway, so I know a lot of people have been asking questions or asking me questions about it, and I'll just go ahead and answer them. They're already on the market now, so I figured I'd talk. But excellent machine, rugged. I mean, that's a beautiful fit finish. I mean, looks like something that would last years and years. You just can't tear it up. It's just a rugged machine. Okay, I appreciate it.